Hello, hello. This video I prepared for you guys in response to a slew of direct messages, emails, texts that I got from you guys, from my patients, from friends, family, last week when I was on vacation because there was that FDA-approved new injectable for cellulite. So you may not have heard of it. I will tell you all about it right here. So I prepared. I got so many different questions about this. When is it going to be available? How much is it going to cost? What is it going to be like? Is it going to be painful? What are the downsides? Is it really going to work? Is it going to be a long-term fix for cellulite? Is this finally something that we can all do for our cellulite? So I have an information-packed video for you guys that I put together that will hopefully answer all of those questions for you. So first of all, stop blaming yourself for cellulite, okay? It's not because of what you're eating. It's not because you're not exercising enough. So cellulite is something that is based on hormones. So about 9 out of 10 women have cellulite. So yes, if you have it, you're in very good company. You may not be talking about it with each other, but believe me, in my office, it comes up a lot because a lot of women are dealing with it. Only 10% of men, hate them. No, love them, love my hubby, but hate the fact that they don't have cellulite. So right now, guys, there are tons of creams, there are lotions, there are devices, there are gadgets, there are brushes. There's a lot of things out there that claim to be amazing for cellulite. Most of them don't do much at all. If they do anything, it's temporary, right? They can temporarily improve the appearance of cellulite. How do you improve the appearance of cellulite? You can stimulate circulation, boost circulation, sort of make the area sort of swell a little bit. Some of the ingredients are beneficial in the long term in that they thicken the dermal layer of the skin. So if you imagine you've got your marshmallow fluff sandwich, if your top slice of bread is really weak, and you're pulling down with those fibrous septae, it's more likely to buckle, it's more likely to collapse, and the fat lobules are more likely to pooch out and herniate, so you're more likely to see those irregularities. If you can get like a big, strong, tough piece of sourdough bread, and you put that at the top of your sandwich, your cellulite's gonna look better, right? So if you can thicken the dermal layer with ingredients like peptides, collagens, retinoids, retinol, glycolic acid, vitamin A derivatives, things that are going to stimulate the collagen layer and help with that strength and firmness of the skin, that will over time have a longer term benefit on cellulite. But again, it's subtle. Like, we're not talking about dramatically improving the appearance of medium, you know, moderate to severe cellulite and dimples. So what's going to do that? Right now, there are a couple of very invasive procedures that are available. They have a lot of downtime, a lot of swelling. You know, I do some of them and have done some of them, and they use tumescent anesthesia where I'm really pumping up the area with flooding it with lidocaine, a very dilute form of lidocaine, and I'm actually like slicing those fibrous septae. I know that sounds totally gross, but that's kind of what's available right now if you're looking for like a long-term solution, and there's a lot of downtime with that, and it takes a lot of technical skill, you know, to really execute that procedure properly, and it really only works in very select patients. So it's just not an ideal option for most people who are dealing with cellulite. Okay, and that brings us to QWO. QWO, which was just FDA approved for moderate to severe cellulite in the buttock of women. So that's what they got FDA approval for. Will we end up using it off label for the back of the thighs, the sides of the thighs, maybe even the arms? I've seen cellulite in the arms. It's possible. We do a lot of procedures off label in dermatology. For example, I am constantly injecting the tear trough area with Bellatero. Is Bellatero FDA approved for tear trough, you know, deformity? No. But do I find that it's an incredibly effective injectable procedure for that area? Yes. So that's something dermatologists are used to all the time. So if you have cellulite you know, on your lateral thigh, and you read this press release about quo, and they talk about the buttock and how it's only FDA approved for the buttock. Relax, it will probably end up being something that we can apply to those other areas as well if it ends up being something that you're interested in. Okay, so quo uses an enzyme called collagenase. Collagenase, this particular collagenase, actually chews up, it breaks down the fibrous septae. So ironically, most of the time I'm talking to my patients about preserving their collagen, not letting things chew it and break it down. We're trying to protect against oxidative stress. We're trying to protect against UV rays and infrared light and blue light and, you know, pollution and all those things that are triggering these enzymes that are acting like Pac-Man and eating away at our collagen and causing us to lose the firmness, the elasticity, you know, and the strength and healthy, beautiful look of our skin. In cellulite, we want the collagen gone. We want to chew it away, because if you imagine that fiber septae that's pulling down and creating that dimple, if you chew it away, if you release it, right, then all of a sudden the surface is nice and smooth. So your piece of bread, the top, the skin layer, is going to be smooth. It's not going to have the shadows that we normally see with cellulite. So let's talk about the studies. Let's talk about the evidence, because I'm super evidence-based. I like to see results, and I know my colleagues do too. So, and so do my patients, right? It's nice to have a placebo effect, but you really want the real thing. So this is the part that I find particularly intriguing. This is one of the largest studies ever performed on cellulite. There are over 845 participants, and one of the things I really loved about the way that the company did this is that they included over 1/3 of those subjects have skin of color. There's so many derm studies out there where they just do it on white women and they don't include people with skin of color. I specifically trained on skin of color. I trained in Brooklyn. I covered a bunch of hospitals, the majority of which had patients with skin of color, all different types. And that is huge, because skin of color reacts differently to things. In particular with this, so this is an injectable, right? So you sort of inject into the dimple, you're going to inject that collagenase, it's going to dissolve away that fibrous septae. You're going to be left with swelling, you're going to be left with bruising. And if you have skin of color, you're probably going to be left with something called post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, right? So that's a stain. I can tell you that my patients who have skin of color, when they deal with stains, post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, PIH, if it's after, say, a cat scratches them or they get a scrape, or it's after a bug bite, or it's after an acne pimple and they have the stain left over, a lot of the time, that brown spot, the stain that lasts sometimes for months, actually affects their quality of life and is more disturbing emotionally to that patient than the initial skin issue was. So it's something we can't ignore. Okay, so what are the risks that we know about so far with quo? So we've got swelling, we've got bruising, definitely bruising. Bruising in the buttock and the thigh area, guys, lasts a while. It can last 2 weeks easily. So this is the kind of procedure that you're not gonna wanna do during the summer months. So I think people start to think about their cellulite in the spring, in the summer, as they're wearing less clothes, as the sun is coming out. This is the kind of thing you wanna plan ahead. You wanna be starting these procedures. It's a series of procedures. You wanna be starting it probably in the fall. You wanna be, you know, really taking care of this during the winter. And you don't want to be scheduling a vacation in a hot, sunny climate when you're recovering from this, if you care about pictures, you care what you look like. So what the protocol right now looks like, it's a series of about 3 injections, and they're spaced about 3 to 4 weeks apart. So in the study, they were done 21 days apart, so about 3 weeks apart. And it took a series of injections to get those dramatic results that the FDA approved. And I've seen the pictures, guys, they're dramatic. It really is impressive. This isn't, you know, sort of like a minor improvement. This is a real perceptible improvement in the appearance of cellulite, which is very exciting. And of course, the other side effect that we're all gonna worry about is gonna be post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, PIH, staining of the skin, dark marks. Anytime there's inflammation and bruising, there's always the risk that there's going to be a dark mark left over. So that's something we have to keep an eye out for. How common is that? How often is it happening? All these safety studies are ongoing. There's, I believe there's a 5-year safety study that's still going on for Quo. Quo's not available yet. It's going to become commercially available supposedly spring of 2021, at which point we are going to find out what it's going to cost. That's a big question mark right now. Unfortunately, you know, this one company, this is sort of the only molecule that's acting like this. So I feel like right now when there's like a monopoly in an area, right, when Botox came out before like Dysport came out, the pricing, you know, can get pretty high because nothing else is competing and driving the prices down. So I am hoping that the company prices this competitively, you know, makes it available and accessible to people who, you know, who it bothers them. With any new procedure, there's always a learning curve. There's a learning curve, you know, when it comes to technique. I consider myself an expert injector. So I think I carry a syringe all day in one hand, and then sometimes I pick up a laser, but that's basically what my days are like. I'm very good with hand-eye coordination and the artistic, you know, components of injections. I know how to palpate depth. I know how to feel for where I am underneath the skin. And that's just an experience thing, and it's something you either got or you don't, but it really can be dramatically improved over time with tons and tons of experience injecting. So you do want to go to somebody who has a lot of experience injecting. I think from that perspective, it's going to be pretty easy to implement into the practice. I don't think that's going to be that big of a learning curve, but I do think that there's always a learning curve with any new procedure. You know, the first couple of patients that are treated, you know, it's, you never really, until you get it in your hands. Clinical trials are one thing, they're done in a very controlled environment. You know, until you start, you know, executing, doing the procedure yourself in real life settings with real life people who are going to go to the gym later or going to drink, you know, a glass of wine later, or, you know, whatever it is that maybe they were taking, you know, some kind of a turmeric supplement or something with vitamin E that thin the blood, and they're more likely to have swelling and bruising and tenderness afterwards. Like, we're going to sort of learn the nuances of this procedure and, you know, how to really counsel our patients effectively regarding the risk-benefit ratio, because there's always a risk-benefit ratio. So as we learn that, I will keep you guys posted. I'll let you guys know. But as of now, it's pretty exciting. There's really been a lack of effective treatments in this space for so long. So, you know, I hope that this lives up to the hype. I hope that the before and after pictures that I've seen are similar to the results that I'll be achieving in my office come spring 2021. I'll set up a live Instagram with you guys if you have any questions on this topic. Obviously, feel free to DM me, ask any questions below. You know, I love hearing from you guys. And I really hope this was helpful. And in the meanwhile, use some self-tanner, give yourself a little massage, and get out there with your shorts, because who cares? We all have cellulite, okay? So not the end of the world. All right, guys. Mwah.